Today we are here to find the concavity and inflection points of a given equation. Our given equation is ln x squared minus 2, and we have put it up here on the graph depicted by the red line. And in order to do so, we are going to have to find the first and second derivatives and set the second derivative equal to 0 in order to find our inflection points, and from there we can find the concavity of the overall graph.
And then the blue line depicted here is the second derivative that we found, and we can show you how to do the math over here.
So like we said before, we're going to have to find the first derivative, and set the second derivative equal to 0. So I'm going to show you how to find the first derivative. So we start out with ln natural log x squared minus 2. In order to find the first derivative of this, we're going to have to chain rule it, which means we're going to have to find an f of x and a g of x equation, an inside and an outside function. The outside function is just simply going to be ln x, and the inside function is going to be x squared minus 2. So with comparison to the chain rule, first we're going to find the derivative of ln. Ln of x is simply 1 over x. Now next we're going to have to plug in the original equation back in to our derivative of the first equation, and then multiply that by the derivative of the g of x. So what we're going to do here is we're going to put in x squared minus 2 for x. We just took the g of x and put it in for x. And then we're going to have to multiply this by the derivative of g of x, which is just simply by power rule 2x. So now after multiplying those together, we get 2x over x squared minus 2. Now this is our first derivative, and from this point we're going to have to find our second derivative, and Dana's going to show. So now that Dana found our second derivative, our objective is to set that second derivative equal to 0 in order to find inflection points. And inflection points are going to be able to help us understand the concavity and behavior of the function as a whole. So we're going to start with our second derivative here. And we're going to set this second derivative equal to 0. Now, in order to do that, it looks difficult, but it's actually pretty easy. So first of all, we're going to multiply both sides by x squared minus 2 squared. And when we do that, we're going to be able to cancel out the denominator as a whole here and just be left with negative 2x squared minus 4 equals 0, which if you can notice here, it is our numerator for our second derivative. So now from here, we are going to add both sides of the equation by 4, which would give us negative 2x squared equals 4. And then after that, we're going to divide both sides by negative 2, which is going to give us x squared equals negative 2. So now, in order to find x by itself, we're going to have to square root both sides. And if you know from normal math, you can't square root a negative number. So our conclusion here is that, I'll just bring it up here to just have more room. We have x equals the square root of negative 2. And I believe that's a plus or minus, I'll just check on that. But regardless, when you square root a negative number, you're gonna end up with an imaginary number. So we're pretty much getting here, x equals, it was negative 2i, 2i. So whenever we find that these imaginary numbers, we are obviously given a conclusion that we might not be able to find the overall concavity of the graph because there isn't an inflection point. And if there is, it's not something that we can find. So our conclusion here after all of this is these are our inflection points, but I don't believe that these are able to be graphed nor observed to find total concavity.